I was planning on doing this week's video tutorial on styles, but while researching the materials, I found a bug, I believe is a bug. So I am going to do this tutorial on what the bug is, and then my next tutorial will be on how to report this bug. Before we go any further, the first thing we want to do is make sure that we are on the most recent version of LibreOffice. So to do that, I'm going to the LibreOffice download site, and I see there's a 3.3.4 and a 3.4.4. Well, I was using 3.3.4.1, and I found the problem there. So then I downloaded 3.4.4, and that's what version I have here. And to show that, I'm using 3.4.4. Now, the other thing that the people at the Document Foundation want to know is what system am I running this on? Because this might be a bug in one system, like for Windows, which I'm running, and not for Linux or Mac. Or it might work on Windows 32-bit, but not 64-bit. So they'll want to know as much information as possible. So now I'm showing that I am using a Dell Inspiron. They don't care as much about that. They want to know that I'm using Windows Home 7 Premium and that I've got enough memory and I'm using the 64-bit operating system. Also, before submitting any bugs, you're going to want to go to how to report bugs in LibreOffice. And we'll notice that they have the user's mailing list and a bug triage and a thing called Bugzilla. So I've already gone through and looked up this problem there, and a lot of people have responded, not a lot, but they say read the manual, which I brought up here, and also chapter 7, working with styles. There's two of them. So I've got a little bit of background on this and how I believe how it should work, and now I'm going to show how it does work. We have our bulletin numbering here, and we showed how to customize that in a previous tutorial. This week, while covering styles, I was going to include styles of bulletin numbering. And the first part seems to work really well. I've highlighted it. I'm opening my styles. I'm going to my custom bulletin numbering style, numbering, double clicking. It looks great. I've got my blue Roman numeral 1, my teal number 2, and my red custom Roman numeral lowercase. Now when I highlight this all again, going to my bullet style, it looks great. Different spacing, that works. The colors, I've got a red telephone, a blue book, and a purple hand. Now my problem is when I want the style of the paragraph here, I want the first level to be red like the phone, the second level to be blue or teal like the book, and the third level to be purple like the hand. Going to my paragraph, I see my created styles here. Got bullet style 1. And if I look at modify, I have my name bullet style, the next style bullet 2, just as those PDF manuals for LibreOffice said to do. Linked with none, custom categories. And the other thing important was this outline. We have outline level 1, numbering style, my bullet. Second style, same way. We're pointing to level 2, the numbering style. And the organization next style should be level 3. And then the third, I only have 3, but you're supposed to be able to go up to 10. I'm only using 3, which should be sufficient for this tutorial. And we've got our 3. And then the next one would be the default, because we're done. And the numbering style, I'm pointing level 3 and pointing to the My Bullet numbering style. Now, I would think that if I highlight this whole thing and double-click bullet style 1, it would work. And it does, kind of. It makes them all my bullet format 1. And if I look at this now, modify, it still has the outline 1, bullet one. So if I highlight this all, go to bullet style two, it makes them all bullet style two. Now making them all bullet style three, which is okay, but it's not, the third level's correct, but the first and second are not correct. So looking through some of the defects, one of them said that it does work. Let me highlight this whole thing, set it back to the default. What they were suggesting as a answer is you highlight your first level, hold down control, get your next, then come down to your style sheet, level one, bullet style one. Now we want to highlight all our level twos. And this is a little bit tedious and kind of difficult to do. There's a good chance of missing some. Now I got to scroll down again to find my bullet style too. So I don't think that that's the way that they intended to do it. And now doing level three. And there's a chance of me missing one. Now I got to get, let's see if I can get that. So this, it can work. It's just not really, oops, now I got to scroll down and find my style three. And it does give me the result I want, but it's a lot of work to get there is my point. And why am I creating this bullet style, giving it the level one and setting in my next style? What's the purpose of that? If I need to go in and highlight these each individually anyway. So that's my bug or my problem. And I'd like to see if that's what they intended or if there's a better way to paragraph format my bullets and numbering.